Before we move on to today's what if video, let's recap the last part. Beerus comes to Earth and fights Goku. Goku's ultimate form impresses Beerus so much that Beerus decides that he will take Goku and Vegeta to his planet to train. During this short 3-month period, Goku and Vegeta master the powers of Super Saiyan God and are able to reach new heights of power. This is when Whis comes back from Earth with 3 new students. They were none other than Nappa, Raditz, and Piccolo, who have come to master God Ki. However, a few months later, Cell appears on Earth again, rampaging around the entire Earth. This Cell was tremendously powerful, having both the cells of Gohan and Golden King Cole. Goku tries and saves the day. However, even in Super Saiyan Blue, Cell was seemingly ahead of Goku, and Goku could not keep up with Cell. However, right in the middle of the fight, Goku suddenly powers down and closes his eyes. He starts to power up again, and his power is skyrocketing into realms never seen before. What form could Goku unveil today? Well, you have to find out today on Dragon Ball Super. So, Goku powers up and powers up and powers up. Suddenly, a red aura coats him. However, his hair seemingly stands up, depreciating this form from the Super Saiyan God transformation. This was none other than Super Saiyan God stacked on top of his ultimate form. Cell was impressed at Goku's power, and Goku and Cell lunged each other, crossing and crossing and crossing, trading blows and punches. However, Goku seems to remain unscattered as he punches Cell away, following him in his footsteps. Cell could not visualize how powerful Goku was. He couldn't even see the punches that landed on him. Goku decides that he will end this now. He knew Cell was a threat, so he charges up his full power Kamehameha. The Kamehameha sending Cell flying into the air, killing him once and for all. Gohan was impressed at Goku's power. He never knew that one could master such strength. So this led to Gohan actually training even more than he did before, trying to also tap into the powers of God Ki. Now, we are in the revival Frieza saga, where a ship suddenly flies towards Gohan at amazing speeds. Gohan could sense a huge energy lying on the ship. Wait, it wasn't one huge energy, it was 2 huge energies. They were none other than Frieza and King Cold, who have come back for revenge. Both of them turn into their golden forms, knowing that Gohan cannot be underestimated. Gohan powers up as well into his ultimate form. However, during this exchange, Gohan realizes that his ultimate form wasn't enough to match both of them together. So, he powers up once more into Super Saiyan God? Wrong. This is Super Saiyan God stacked on top of his ultimate form, the same form that Goku used to defeat Cell. Gohan lunges a Kamehameha towards Golden Frieza and Golden King Cole, sending them flying into the atmosphere, and then the Kamehameha explodes, eradicating them once and for all. Gohan managed to save the Earth from this threat. Now, we are going on into the Universe 6 tournament. So, before we move on to the tournament, let's talk about the members chosen by Beerus. Of course, we have Goku and Vegeta, and then we have Gohan in his Super Saiyan God ultimate form, who's actually stronger than Vegeta here, just slightly stronger. And then we have Nappa and Raditz, who both have access to Super Saiyan Blue. Unfortunately, this means Piccolo is left out here, even though he has accessed the powers of God Ki. Also, one thing to take note is that Piccolo in this canon of events still hasn't fused with Kami just yet, so his power is slightly below the rest of the Z fighters, but I have a way for him to catch up soon enough. Now, for the actual tournament, Nappa, the weakest of the group, decided that he would take up the mantle of being the first fighter. He faces up against Botamo and easily knocks Botamo out of the ring with some tricks up his sleeve. Next up, we have Frost against Nappa. This fight wasn't even a challenge and ended in like 2 seconds because Nappa hates Frieza, and that guy really looks like Frieza. Next up, we have Magetta. Nappa actually struggles a little bit here because Magetta is actually seriously quite strong. However, after throwing insults left and right at Magetta, Nappa manages to eliminate Magetta once and for all, causing him to defeat 3 fighters from universe 6. Now, the 4th fighter is none other than Kaba. Nappa is pretty interested in the Saiyans from universe 6 and decides that he will actually teach Kaba the ways of a Super Saiyan. He transforms into the legendary Super Saiyan transformation, and Kaba is shocked at this revelation. He didn't know that Saiyans could even transform. After provoking Kaba and continuously pushing Kaba past his limits, Kaba turns into the legendary Super Saiyan. However, his power still pales in comparison to Nappa, so Nappa eliminates Kaba. So, the final contestant, the final barrier to winning this tournament is none other than the Universe 6 Assassin Hit, who will be proved much more of a challenge than you could think. This is because none of them have access to the powers of Kaioken, therefore they are unable to amplify their power. So, will they be able to defeat the powerful and mysterious Assassin Hit? Well, you have to find out next time on Dragon Ball Super.